We are in Washington, D.C. right now.
In the Marriott Hotel.
Yay! And this
is... It's beautiful here!
It's really cold outside. It's beautiful. We're really excited today because, oh my god, there's frost on the cars. And we're gonna... And today we're going to this... What are we doing today, Charisma?
We're gonna go see Beyonce.
We're gonna go watch Beyonce sing
and then we're gonna
live.
Go to the what is it called?
Smithsonian.
She's gonna sing like right in front of us.
Yeah.
Sure. And what is the Obama?
This is all our.
That's not today.
That's not today. This is all our clothes that we have.
Yes.
We have a pretty
it's
messy
pretty
room.
Pretty messy, but you know what? We're having fun. So
yeah.
Whatever.
Okay. Bye.
Where are we?
We're in this place.
DC.
Oh yeah, but still.
And we were just on. Oh my god!
You guys shut up. Yeah.
Okay, bye.
Hey Gabe, how's the trip?
Say bye, Henry.
Okay. Camera suck your brains out.
See that? That's our field teacher, Mr. K. He said he's a teacher. And that's Mr. Grady, our Algebra 1 teacher. Guess what he's doing? He's standing there doing the peace sign.
Which is also known for something else in
English. Named Junior Mod.
With the red eye.
Oh, I should take a picture.
Yeah, I know.
See you in the love days. Oh, crap. This guy, he's a superhuman. This guy's a superhuman. See that guy? That guy right there? If he punches you, you're dead. It's over.
What's crush?
You're never gonna.
Has he punched you before, Alan?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is that true, Justin?
No, he hasn't. But he tackled me when I was playing football.
Oh, okay, now I'm sorry.
Because it was called tackle.
Wait, what do you mean by punch like
this?
Wobble arm!
I'll flip you out.
Are you like punch, like punch?
Okay.
Morning,
like,
Joe.
But look,
yes, Mr. Grady.
That's Mr. Grady right there. And Mr. Grady's right there.
Hey, look, it was
and that's
Joe.
Mr. Kevin.
On MSNBC.
Taking pictures of little kids.
Gabe, what
Mr.
are
Grady
you doing?
Again.
Dude, I.
Hey, oh, God.
Gabe, what
oh,
are you doing?
Got, wait, no,
what
are you doing?
Gabe, what are you doing? You're on camera. You're recording right now.
No. I should get some experience if I'm gonna
hey,
be
that.
What's going on?
It's the end of my career already.
It's working.
You owe me $50.
See that? That's the Washington Monument.
Guess what I got on tape?
This thing zoomed in very far.
I'm filming Washington.
Pushing you
know what I'm saying? That kind of stuff. Show my camera. Yeah, this kind of stuff is gonna be all over the school. Yeah. This is where I'm filmed by. Well, you know it's gonna be all over the school.
Oh crap, that's gonna be on camera.
Well, they don't even
open
the.
My bad.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Grace Cho and I'm in DC right now and it's super, 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 super cold. It's like.
Can I have your autograph?
No! No autographs, please! No autographs, please. Okay. And it's like 10 degrees here. Charisma! No! No pictures, please! No pictures, please.
Can I
bug
your autographs?
No!
She talked to me.
No.
Hey, look, it's a wall of porta potties. It's walls of porta potties. Oh.
My mouth is freezing right now. So is my hand, because it's like 10 degrees here. But you know what? It's okay. It's okay.
Oh, my hand is freezing.
Oh, there's more porta potty. A tree, porta potty, porta potty, porta potty, porta potty, porta potty, porta potty, tree, porta potty, porta potty, porta potty. Blue one. Neon light.
Neon.
Thank you, thank you.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Woo! Cranky mate.
Henry won't do this. I'm on it. I couldn't make it five. four, three.
All right, this is one of those times where it says hurry to hurry.
It's just so impossible that it's comprehended.
Whoa.
Come on, chase me for the show. Chase me.
Whooping on camera.
Dude, chase me.
Oh,
He's disappearing. Nice shoes. Purple pants.
Oh my guys, for now on, he says run, we gotta run again.
Is that what you do if there was a bomb? Push me into it?
So we're gonna get that we took from it and throw it on you.
Oh god.
Now time for hot chocolate, because Rouge is a man's best friend. Offered three buttons.
It's so hot that it exploded.
That
and it's funny because it's freaking cold out here.
It's free and he doesn't like free stuff. What?
Oh, it's a Pepsi, right?
I'm gonna dive it on the curb.
Look at the arms. Look.
Where's Sean go?
Where'd he go?
You gotta stay here.
I survived my life. Shadoom, shit. Get it?
Oh, we're gonna have some dogs.
Where?
Look at this guy.
You see the biggest dog in the Miami, then you leave New York, on my left hand side, you see one from Baltimore. They do not be alarmed and scared because I'm going to be the one. Coming up on my left hand side, you're about to see one of the stones from Alabama. Alabama got the very first stone, which is at the 120th level. They said we have the money to contribute to build Miami, all we can do is donate some of the stones. So that's how the Army Corps of Engineers came up with the idea of donating the commemorative stones you're looking at on the wall right now. We're 280 feet off the ground. Coming up on my left hand side, you're going to see one of the stones in New York. And right here, it's wasting a fire. He's been commended on his work he's done on Earth as a firefighter and receiving his medal. We have 193 different songs in the Miami. Every state and country all come in to George Washington. You want to see them all, come back one day to take a walk on a tour. We do that tour twice a day. We do that 10:30 and 12:00. We do that 96 steps inside of Washington, Miami, from the top to the bottom. So the only thing that you see me do is walk to my car, okay? Coming up on my left-hand side, you can see one of the stones from Baltimore. That right here is where the Miami stood for 25 years without anything has been done. And the reason why was because they ran out of money when they started building. The top five, those stones came from Maine, they were done by machine. The bottom five, those stones came from Baltimore, they were done by Andrew number two. That's what the culture is. That's what the right hand side was the biggest stone in the Miami. That's another one.
Oh, wait!
Now, what happened when they first started building the Washington Monument, they ran out of money. So for 25 years, the monument only stood at that level. And then when the Honorable Prisoners came in and took over the project, because they started getting a lot of complaints from different presidents.
Can we just stand on the ice and make sure we don't step on it?
Yeah. Okay. I have like 6 hours off the boat.
Get a good spot and then we'll meet you over there.
I don't know.
Push me.
No.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
You just...
No. Oh. I didn't get that.
Are you recording?
Oh, gotta keep moving.
Is it recording?
Push it to the...
What do I say? What am I supposed to say?
Oh, guys, I'm gonna punch
you.
So what are we doing here? Stop, Kate! Why are we here? For the concert for Beyonce.
Oh, cool. What have you guys been doing?
This past time.
Hi.
Hopefully this is the most exciting thing you get on film.
Hopefully not. Was he with us the whole time?
Yeah.
Thank you.
And everyone's going swimming. No one's gonna die. Hi, Green Man.
What's up?
Okay, cool. Bye. Say bye.
Hilda.
Ladies. At university, to meet the demands of the new age. Woo! We can do. All this we will do. Now, there are some who question the scale of our ambitions, to suggest that our system cannot tolerate too many big plans. Their memories are short, for they have forgotten what this country has already done, what free men and women can achieve when imagination is joined to common purpose and necessity to courage. What the cynics fail to understand is that the ground has shifted beneath them, that the stale political arguments that have consumed us for so long no longer apply. The question we ask today is not whether our government is too big or too small, but whether it works, whether it helps families find jobs and a decent wage, care they can afford, a retirement that is dignified. Where the answer is yes, we intend to move forward. Where the answer is no, programs will end. And those of us who manage the public dollars will be held to account to spend wisely, reform bad habits, and do our business in the light of day, because only then can we restore the vital trust between the people and their government. Nor is the question before us whether the market is a force for good or evil. Its power to generate wealth and expand freedom is unmatched. But this crisis has reminded us that without a watchful eye, the market can spin out of control. The nation cannot prosper long when it favors only the prosperous. The success of our economy has always depended not just on the size of our gross domestic product, but on the reach of our prosperity, on the ability to extend opportunities to every human heart. Our charity, but because it is the surest route for our economy. As for our common defense, we reject as false the choice between our safety and our ideals. Our founding fathers, faced with perils that we can scarcely imagine, drafted a charter to assure the rule of law and the rights of man, a charter expanded by the blood of generations. Those ideals still light the world, and we will not give them up for expedient sake. And so, to all the other peoples and governments who are watching today, from the greatest capitals to the small village where my father was born, know that America is a friend of each nation and every man, woman, and child who seeks a future of peace and dignity, and we are ready to lead. not just with mental disorders, but with a sturdy alliance of enduring possessions. And it's good that our power will not protect us, nor does it entitle us to do as we please. Instead, I knew that our power alone was full of use, of sturdy enemies and the justice of our God, the force of our example, the temper and qualities of humility and respect. We are the keepers of this legacy. Guided by these principles once more, we can use them to address the demanding need of labor, the greater cooperation and understanding between nations. We'll begin to responsibly lead the optimal people and forge a harder and peace in Afghanistan. With all the friends and former colleagues, we will work tirelessly to lessen the nuclear threat. And we will not be stopped here, we will be planned. We will not apologize for our way of life, nor will we waver any stumble. And for those who seek to advance their aim by abusing strength and stronger energy, we make you not still stronger and cannot be broken. You cannot be broken. You cannot be broken. For we know that our patchwork heritage is a strength, not a weakness. We are a nation of Christians and Muslims, Jews and Hindus, and non-believers. We are shaped by every language and culture, drawn from every end of this earth. And because we have tasted the bitter swell of civil war and segregation, and emerged from that dark chapter stronger and more united, we cannot help but believe that the old hatreds shall someday pass, that the lines of tribes shall soon dissolve, that as the world grows smaller, our common humanity shall reveal itself, and that America must play its role in ushering in a new era of peace. To the Muslim world, we seek a new way forward, based on mutual interest and mutual respect.
Dude.
Okay. Overall, it was a great trip. I really enjoyed being with the 8th grade class this year. Especially somebody. It was a great trip.
Yeah.